Star Wars, Crusade of the Rebellion, by Joe Harrison. Based on characters and situations created by George Lucas. Episode 1, Conspiracy. Time ago, in a galaxy far, far away, there came a time of revolution when rebels united to challenge a tyrannical empire, and this challenge brought great and devastating civil war to the galaxy. The once fledgling Rebel Alliance, now a force to be reckoned with, continues its battle against the Galactic Empire in order to resurrect the Republic it once stood for, and they have just taken a giant leap to their goal. The Death Star, an Imperial battle station of incredible destructive power, has been destroyed. After taking heavy casualties, Luke Skywalker, a newcomer to the Rebel Alliance, took the final charge into the trench of the superweapon, fired, and destroyed the Death Star. But the threat of the Empire is far from over. Even as the evil Emperor Palpatine mends his wounds, there are other dangers that lurk within the shadows of his vile regime. And these dangers may not only be a threat to the Rebel Alliance, but to the Emperor himself.
Omega Flight. Lord Teivel has requested that you continue your patrol of the surrounding sectors until further notice.
Acknowledged, Antaeus.
Corporal.
Yes, sir?
Take Squad 3 down to Hangar Bay 7. Have them meet with Lord Teivel's shuttle. They shall be accompanying him to the surface.
Understood, sir. All right, men. Let's move out.
I see we're coming up on the planet now. Lieutenant, patch me through to the excavation site's control center.
Yes, sir.
Apophis Control, this is the Imperial Star Destroyer Antaeus. We have just entered orbit. Please inform Supreme Overseer Rao that Lord Teivel's personal shuttle is preparing for launch.
Understood, Antaeus. Preparations have already been underway. We know he has been most anxious to see our findings here. Control out.
Bridge to Shuttle Deathwing. I have just made communication with the surface. You are cleared for launch.
Lieutenant, get those Wookiees under control.
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes, that's it. Good.
Lord Overseer, Lord Overseer.
Oh yes, Commander Tredec. What is it?
Sir, they are reporting problems with the slaves in Section Q9. Some of the Wookiees are beginning to collapse from all the stress, sir.
And what's this? Insubordination? And do you mean to tell me that Lieutenant Teivel is tolerating such behavior?
Sir, I don't think it's so much toleration as it is the inability to do otherwise. I'm afraid it's a situation he has no control over.
Then control must be taken. Do you see this vibro-whip, Commander? An invention of Black Sun, as I understand it. We have been supplied here with only the best in motivational technology. Harsh. Quick. Effective.
Ah, your point is well taken, Lord Overseer.
Good. Now, please inform Lieutenant Havoc that he is to produce results in his sector immediately, or it shall be his spine that is subject to our motivational technology.
Yes, sir.
Sir, Lord Overseer, sir.
What is it now?
Sir, it's Lord Teivel, sir. He's on his way to the surface.
Do you mean to tell me that I was not informed the moment his flagship arrived?
Sir, there was no time. The ship emerged from hyperspace and almost immediately dispatched the shuttle for the surface.
Fool. I specifically requested that I be alerted the moment the Governor's flagship entered the system. How does it feel, Lieutenant, having the cord of my whip constricting your throat, to have the ultrasonic vibrations eating into your very flesh?
Please, my lord.
One tug. That's all it would take. One tug. Your life is in my hands. Remember that, Lieutenant. The next time I give you a specific command.
Lord Overseer, Governor Teivel's shuttle.
Supreme Overseer Rao to X-Ray 1. Dispatch the Honor Guard to landing pad B7. Troopers, be still. Lord Teivel, we are very pleased to have you here. Just as I know you will be pleased with our latest discoveries, I'm sure you are most eager to see the... I see my lord wishes to go straight to the site. If you wish, I can show you the way.
My lord? My lord! I'm sure you're here to observe our latest findings. If you'll just follow me, sir. You'll notice that we've uncovered many ruins here. There was definitely an ancient civilization here, just as you predicted there would be, sir. This ancient wall we uncovered has been an incredible key in our efforts. It has actually aided us in pinpointing many of the areas to focus our digging. We've uncovered some truly amazing... Sir? Do you see something? I see you're standing there by that wall, following the symbols with your hands.
Hieroglyphs.
What was that, my lord?
They are called hieroglyphs, Commander Trenick.
Ah. yes, sir. Hieroglyphs.
Such reverence for the power. They knew they had something extraordinary. But they didn't know how to use it.
Sir?
The ancient civilization that lived here. They had no idea what they were dealing with. Fortunate, however, for me.
Yes, sir.
Huh. Of course, history means nothing to you, Commander. You're just a rank, a uniform, a mind drilled with shallow military bantha fodder. You do not know, do not understand the depth, the life that even something as simple and ancient as this wall holds.
Sir, I
it matters not. Quickly, Commander. Take me to them.
Yes, sir. This way.
Why there's so much moisture down here. It truly is astounding. Well, this is it. This is the temple.
Astounding. Simply astounding.
Some of the things, the artifacts we have uncovered, are truly beyond anything we have ever seen. These old creatures have
ancient.
These ancient creatures had access to a technology that surpasses even some of what we have today, my lord.
Does it surprise you, Commander? Of course it does. Because these are a people who came long before. Surely we must condescend to them.
No, sir. I didn't...
Silence! Mean... Take me to them. Now.
Yes, sir. This way, my lord. Here they are, my lord.
They are beautiful. So much raw power. I can feel it.
My lord.
As you can see, my lord, we have only uncovered three of them. But I have full confidence that we will soon find the other four.
Even with just three, so much power.
Sir?
Observe, Commander, as I take just one of them, as I take aim at my target, observe.
By the Emperor! What is that? You unleash some sort of black smoke. It's like black water suspended in midair, and it's... Oh, it's spiraling, twisting in on itself. It's heading towards... It's lifting him up off the ground and spinning him around. By the nine hells, what is it doing to him? It is desk, it is his body! What was that?
The stroke of Emperor Palpatine's final hour.
Dilla Command, this is the Sovereign requesting permission to land. I am transmitting my clearance code.
Sovereign, we have you on our screens. Your code has been cleared. Welcome back, Captain Tanner.
It's good to be back, Commander Cade.
I trust your mission was a success? That bad, huh? Well, I'm sure we'll hear all the details in the assembly. Lady Mothma has been worried about you.
Well, let her know she doesn't have to worry anymore. About me, anyway. Tell her the news isn't wonderful.
Please, please. I know we are all tired. This war has been long and exhausting. But we've come so far. And we cannot afford to let any threat slip past. So please, hear me out.
We're listening, Lady Mothma.
Thank you, Leia. Now, as I was saying, this new threat originates in the Cortana system, located on the...
The Cortana system is on the border of the core rim.
Indeed.
But that's suicide. Working that close to the Imperial core?
I know, Commander Kate. But it is a risk we will have to take. And if you will allow me to continue, you will realize that the risk is not as great as it seems. The Cortana system is currently under the jurisdiction of Grand Moff Gilvan Teivel.
Why does that sound familiar?
Because Governor Teivel was the architect of the Barrage, or Suicide-class destroyer. The ship that was responsible for the Rock Moon's destruction. And if you can remember the devastation wrought by that destroyer, you will understand the importance of this mission. Governor Teivel, whom was given control of the Cortana system several years ago, had a starship construction facility built on the third moon. Vectar shipyards, which had at one time been responsible for providing the Empire with deadly starfighters and warships alongside Quat drive yards and Sinar fleet systems. However, after a falling out with Quat drive yards, who insisted they could replace Teivel's suicide destroyers with a newer, better model, Vectar shipyard ceased to manufacture. At least for the Empire, anyway. Now, with the destruction of the Death Star, the Emperor is looking for help from any and all resources. This means that Vectar Shipyards has been recommissioned, and Governor Teivel is constructing another suicide destroyer. Now you understand the importance.
I'm afraid it gets worse.
Captain Tanner, you've returned.
Yeah, and I'm afraid the news I have is nothing short of devastating, as usual.
What is it, Captain?
Intel intercepted a number of transmissions moving between Coruscant and Cortani III, Your Highness. It appears we were misinformed. Teivel is not constructing one new suicide destroyer, but three. And I'm afraid there's still more, m'lady.
What else, Captain?
It's the Colonel, m'lady. According to my contact on Prempta 4, he's scheduled for termination in 48 standard hours.
No.
I'm afraid so. Emperor's turning his rage over the destruction of the Death Star on rebel prisoners they've been keeping. Especially important, high-ranking ones.
Have we made any kind of contact with him?
Unfortunately not, m'lady. He's being kept in a high-security wing. If he's paying attention, he probably knows about the Empire's defeat at Yavin right now. Maybe that'll make him a bit more understanding of our delay in getting him out of there.
After several months in an Imperial prison.
Remember, m'lady, he is a war veteran. This isn't the first time he's been detained by the Empire. He'll be fine.
Fine. In 48 hours, he could be dead, Captain.
We will get him out, m'lady.
Will they never quiet down?
Everybody shut up.
Captain Tyson.
That was the one successful part of my mission.
Captain, it's so good to see you again. It has been quite a while.
Well, 6 years in a hospital ward might have something to do with it. The color white. Ugh, I never want to see that color again.
Well, in that case, I pity the next stormtrooper who crosses your path.
Do you really?
No, not really.
I didn't think so.
I don't believe I've had the pleasure.
Ah, Leia. This is Captain Blair Tyson.
Captain Blair Tyson? General Dodona's second in command during the Battle of Harak. Yes, he had spoken to me of you before. It is a pleasure to finally meet you, Captain.
Princess Leia Organa, it is a pleasure to meet you as well. And please, Blair, I've never been fond of ranks and titles.
Oh, believe me, I agree completely. No one seems to listen to me around here, but I'll say this to you anyway. Just call me Leia.
Well, Captain, you are certainly looking better.
Yes, the meta-techs on Sankara applied synth skin to my exposed cybernetic implants and prosthetics, including giving me a working mouth. They were also able to enhance my vocoder.
Well, I'm sure it was trying, but I assume you are not opposed to the results?
No, just a shame how much time was wasted.
I know you're disappointed about not being around for the battle, but don't worry, Captain. If everything goes according to plan, there will be plenty of opportunities to make up for lost time.
Ladies, if you please.
Oh, my apologies, Lieutenant Hurrix. I had lost track.
You were talking about this Governor Teivel and his suicide destroyers.
Ah, yes. Well, unfortunately, we must postpone the rest of this meeting as something has come to my attention that must be dealt with. The meeting is adjourned. Captain Tanner, Captain Tyson, Leia, if you'll accompany me to my office.
Better have a clafin' good reason for disturbing my rest after a long trip back home, Commander Hawk.
Yes, sir. Sorry, sir. I hope it is, too.
What? What are you talking about?
There is an inbound shuttle, sir. We were contacted and told to inform you that you'd be receiving a guest, sir.
Guest?
Yes, sir. Nothing else.
I have a bad feeling about this.
I'm sorry I didn't catch that, sir.
Nothing. I will be up in a moment. Teivel out. Your Majesty, this is a surprise, to be sure.
A bad one, Governor Teivel.
No, sire. It's just that I would have prepared a better welcoming committee had I known.
Ah, but then I would not have caught you in the midst of your work, Governor.
Sire?
I've come to inspect the progress of the destroyers.
With all due respect, Your Majesty, I could simply have forwarded you
a report. Yes. But I want to see the progress for myself, Governor.
Yes, sire. If that is your wish. If you'll board this transport skiff. This transport will take us through the construction hangar. You will have a clear view of number 002. Sire, I am pleased that you have decided to have my destroyers remanufactured.
Indeed. Perhaps you may now reconcile with Quat Drive Yards.
Perhaps.
Excellent. Truly excellent.
You'll note that we have stripped them of unnecessary structures. They appear much sleeker now, yet with the same effect as the prototype.
The prototype was truly effective.
Yes, sire.
You know, Governor, with all of these destroyers under your command,
It would be very easy for you to destroy Imperial Center.
Sire?
Oh yes, Governor. I am quite aware of your feelings toward me.
Your Majesty, I do not know
what you are. I admire you, Governor Teivel. You remind me of myself. Your greed for power and dominance has made you strong-minded. If only all officials shared the same mind power as you and I. But I would be out of a job then, wouldn't I?
Sire, if you are insinuating I would ever attempt to take control, you need not fear me, I assure you.
Good. Very good.
Sire, I must say I was very astounded to hear of the Death Star's fate.
Of course, Governor. I want to have one last look.
Yes, Sire.
Can you feel it, Governor? Such power, such strength.
Yes, Sire. These destroyers will deliver a powerful blow against the rebels.
Indeed, indeed. That's not what I was referring to, Governor.
If you'll look over this way, Sire, you will see that we have been making some experimental changes with how the outer shell is applied to the destroyer. It's a new setup that I believe many other manufacturers could benefit greatly from. I am sorry to see you leave so soon, Your Majesty.
Duty calls, Governor. Your work here is indeed very impressive. However, I suggest an increase in speed efficiency. The sooner they are finished...
Yes, Sire. Of course.
Oh, and Governor Teivel?
Yes, Sire?
I do not fear you. I could and would crush you the minute you opposed me. Do not forget the tractor movement. And one other thing, Governor... I know you're hiding something.
Not again, Your Majesty. As I have said before, I have no idea what you mean. You dispatched an entire regiment of troopers to search my facilities, and they found nothing. If you could tell me what it is you think I have, Your Excellency, then perhaps...
Tread carefully, Governor Teivel. I am watching you.
Sight for far too long. But soon, yes, soon, it will all be over.
He suspects us. He has to. He even brought up the tractor movement.
The Emperor says that to all Moffs, Captain Vilmer. It is purely routine. And besides, if Teivel's plan works, we will not have to worry about Palpatine for much longer.
I'm not sure about this. You should take care not to completely ignore the possibility that the Emperor may suspect something.
Let me put it this way, General Krail. Of course our dear Emperor is going to be worried, even if he insists he isn't. Of any force under his ruling that is slowly gaining some ground, which is exactly what is happening here. By constructing these three new suicide destroyers, we will be a formidable threat to Palpatine. He is being cautious. Of course, he also has no idea that for the past several years, we've been continuing to manufacture war vessels. And of course, I have other tricks up my sleeve.
Sometimes I'm unsure why you're doing this, when there is clear evidence that all previous attempts of mutiny have failed.
And sometimes I am unsure why you joined this mutinous group, Captain.
I joined because I believe in the true Empire.
That is why we all joined, Captain. Our vision is of a true empire, governed by a true Imperial. Not a Sith Lord. This is not the Sith Empire. The Sith had their run in the old days. There is no room for this hokey force of theirs in this new galaxy.
The Jedi used the Force, and they were considered enemies of the state. Therefore, should not the Sith also be considered enemies?
An excellent point, Admiral Karn. And even if that was not enough to convince us, it is clear to me that these Force users are unfit to rule this Empire. An entire battle station that should not have fallen so quickly, and yet the Emperor just sat back and watched as it went to its doom. If that had been under different control...
I remind you that it was under Tarkin's...
Tarkin was a fool, a hand puppet of the Emperor. He would not listen to reason. He decided he would rather lick the boots of the Emperor than take control of an empire that is rightfully ours.
If that's true, then perhaps we should take in consideration that Tarkin warned the Emperor about Marty. I'm sorry, Governor, but I just want to be realistic. Careful. I believe in the vision of the true Empire. Honest. But I'm a little unsure if this act can actually be pulled off.
Your incompetence is becoming a thorn in my side, Captain. But then again, I should have expected this.
What do you mean?
Surely, Captain, you've read, or at least heard, stories in which there is a mutinous group, and one of them begins to back out because he is a coward. The leader of the group, of course, is obligated to do away with the coward for fear that he will talk.
Are you threatening me, Governor?
Are you threatening us, Captain?
My loyalty is to the true Empire.
Excellent. Excellent. But if I find that your loyalty is elsewhere, Captain, I believe you are familiar with the reputation of my bodyguard, Mr. Kale.
Yes. I am familiar.
Good.
Since then, we have been trying our best to better filter the audio processors. Luckily, with Commander Cade on the job, it is coming along quite well.
I've noticed. The sound seemed a lot sharper than it was the last time I was here.
Ah, Major. I see you are already here. Good. Captain Tyson, may I introduce Major Ariadne of Special Forces?
Captain Tyson, I've heard a great deal about you. It's a pleasure to finally meet you.
Major Ariadne, you know, even on Sankara, I heard something about a Spec Force officer. A green Twi'lek who was giving the Imp Invaders in Argnor 3 a lot of trouble.
I did my duty.
Please, everyone take a seat. Now, the reason why I've called you here is that we have run into a problem.
What kind of problem?
Colonel Leedock.
That about sums it up right there.
Please, this is a serious matter, Captain.
Yes, ma'am.
Colonel Leedock. He's been held in an Imperial prison for the last several months.
What?
I'm afraid Leia is correct. He was captured by the Empire while on a mission on Calabar, and is currently being detained in the Imperial prison on Premtor 4.
Several months? But why? Why didn't anyone...
We were preparing to, Captain. Please believe me. We had every intention of rescuing him. But as we were about to send out a team... Leia arrived not only with the plans for the Death Star, but the battle station itself, tracking not far behind. All available soldiers were needed to remain at Yavin. I'm sorry, Tyson. I know he is your friend.
No. No, I understand.
However, I'm afraid the situation has become much worse. Captain Tanner?
Intel said that the Colonel is to be executed in less than 48 standard hours.
No. No, we've got to help him. We have to get to him now.
I agree wholeheartedly, Captain.
I'll make preparations to go to...
Blair, I'm afraid you were needed here for other preparations.
They can wait. Lida can't.
I'm afraid I can't let you go, Captain. Your presence here is required.
And what is so important as to keep me from going to help my friend?
We will discuss the reason soon. For now, I just need you to trust that the reason is important and that Colonel Leedock would not approve if you ignored it to come help him.
If not me, then who?
Well...
If I may, m'lady, I believe I have the perfect team in mind for the job, Captain. Two of our agents, who, if I'm not mistaken, are only within a day's travel of Preemptor 4, on their return home from their latest mission.
I'm just saying, if you had given me more room to work, we could have had it done in half the time.
Look, if you're going to nag me about this all the way back to Thyla, I'll drop you off at the nearest spaceport, and you can find your own ride.
Admiral, this is my ship. If anyone's getting the boot, it's gonna be you.
Your ship? Since when did this become your ship?
Since they confiscated the truly sorry, that's when.
What does that have to do with
it? We're receiving a priority one transmission from Thyla Command.
Punch it up. And we'll continue this discussion afterwards.
Whatever you say, Hotshot.
Kyle, Jan, I have a new mission for you.
Calling upon the aid of two valuable rebel agents, the rescue of the prisoner of war, Colonel Leedock, is imminent. But the Alliance knows that the Imperial prison on Preemptor 4 is not one to be dealt with lightly. And time is pressing. With only 2 days before the termination of the Colonel, the rescue mission will have to be swift and stealthy. Events have been set into motion, and the beginning of a dangerous time has begun. Threats are rising in the shadows, and the future of the galaxy has become clouded. Star Wars Crusade of the Rebellion, Episode 1, by Joe Harrison. Based on characters and situations created by George Lucas. Featured in the cast were Jesse Lowther as Grand Moff Teivel, Silas Carter as Mon Mothma and Blair Tyson, Andrew Gilbertson as Captain Tanner, Jim Perry as Supreme Overseer Rawl, Christopher Walker as Commander Tredic, Timothy Harrison as the Emperor, Catherine Rinella as Princess Leia, Eric Ulp as Commander Cade, Kevin Trainer as Commander Hawk, Julia Harrison as Major Ariadne, David J.G. Doyle as Admiral Karn, River Kanoff as General Crail, James Leeper as Captain Vilmer, Jeff Lincoln as Stormtrooper 1, Braden Ebert as Stormtrooper 2, Cullen Bentley as Apophis Control Officer, with Christina Arisa as Jan Ors and Ashton Howard as Kyle Katarn. Additional voices by Joe Harrison. This is River Kanoff. Star Wars Crusade of the Rebellion was distributed by Lion's Mouth Entertainment and directed by Joe Harrison. Sound design for Lucasfilm by Ben Burtt. Music by John Williams. Casting, editing, sound design, music supervision, script, and story by Joe Harrison. Mixing and post-production was realized on Adobe Audition and Audacity. Special thanks to Brian Daly, Nathan P. Butler, Star Wars Fanworks, and the Galactic Senate. And a very special thanks to George Lucas for providing us with a galaxy full of endless possibilities. Star Wars Crusade of the Rebellion will continue in Episode 2, coming soon to lionsmouthent.net. This production was produced for and by the fans. All materials, including music, names, and sound effects, are copyright to their original creators. No infringing claims are intended. Lion's Mouth Entertainment is a non-profit company and is not affiliated with or endorsed by Lucasfilm Limited or the Walt Disney Company. Story copyright 2007 to 2014 by Joe Harrison. Visit us online at www.lionsmouthent.net.